What's up, guys? Your boys are back. I'm Ryan, my man George.
What's saying, guys? How you living out there, man? Shout out to the free thinkers.
Yeah, man. So we got Drake War today. I think the last Drake song we did was Money in the Grave, right?
Last Drake song or last, like, remotely popular song? Yo, it's hard for us to find, like, inspiration for pop for mainstream rap these days, man. So yeah. I feel like we're limited to Drake, Kendrick, and Cole. I just feel like we're limited to those three. All right, so we got Drake War that we're going to do today, man. I heard a little bit about this on Twitter. I guess him and The Weeknd have sort of kind of got back on the same page. They're cool again, yeah. I guess. I thought that they were already good to go. I thought they had already made up.
Squash.
From whatever beef they had or whatever the case may be. I guess they weren't on good terms even after that. So, okay, cool. I mean, that's all I know about this one. Let's get into it. Always up for more Drake, man.
Yes, sir.
I mean, let's get into it. Drake War.
Axel. I can already tell this beat's about to be crazy.
Sound hard.
I can already tell.
And I like the vibe. The beat seems to be.
Hey, I don't cop things for resale, don't do iCloud, don't do email. Feds wanna top up man and wire a man like Chubbs the detail. Back when Ricky was doing up Teasdale, I was doing dinner with TZ. I didn't trust no one, swore got limey because got too greasy. Nico never moved Nike, sweatsuit Nike, sweatsuit DG. If man get beaky, ring ring, call up GG, do him up neatly. Used to look up to a man from certain hands with tune on repeat. Thought he was a bad boy then till man got pinched and man went PC. Man went PC just like Dell and went.
Let's run that. The beat is hard.
I love the way they layered that too and how it kind of gradually came in there.
Yeah.
I don't know about the grime type of UK sound that he's got going on, but you know what? I gotta give it up to Drake, man. I say this all the time, man. The dude is super strategic with his moves.
Yeah.
He's right. He knows that this dude, the UK scene though.
It's popping.
Dude, quiet. They got some spitters over there now.
Shout out to Avelino.
Seriously.
We rock with Avelino. Yeah, man. Rex 3-2. There's a couple dudes that we've done on this channel.
So my point.
Check out those videos, by the way.
So my point of saying that is, man, is he sees the movement.
He sees it.
Like, you know what?
Yeah.
Like, you know what? Maybe I need to do a song like a UK type of sound because that's hot. You know what I mean? And they got some spitters over there.
He was doing that early, though, too. He had Skepta on More Life, I believe.
Oh, okay.
He's been going at it, trying to give you little breadcrumbs and there for the last few years, man. So, and then on top of that, he did a freestyle, like you were just saying, I believe, right? Mm-hmm. He did the freestyle where he took that cadence and did his thing, man. And I think he signed some dude, too, to his label. Actually, that was going at him as of recent. From the UK. He was kind of coming at Drake. Now, I don't know what was going on, but he was coming at Drake's neck, and I think he's from the UK, a rapper as well.
Okay.
So I think he may have one or two people from that scene signed to OVO as well. So, all right, I'm done.
Axel. Hey, I don't cop things for resale, don't do iCloud, don't do email. Feds wanna tap up man and wire a man like Chubbs the detail. Back when Ricky was doing up Teasdale, I was doing dinner with TZ. I didn't trust no one, swore got limey cause got too greasy. Nico never moved Nike, sweatsuit Nike, sweatsuit DG. If man get beaky, ring ring, call up GG, do him up neatly. Used to look up to a man from certain hands with tune on repeat. Thought he was a bad boy then till man got pinched and man went PC. Man went PC just like Dell and Windows, some man been those. Before I was ever around Kendo's, I was in Enzo dreaming up Enzo's. The woman I do end up with has to be a bad gal just like Munchie. Can't have no pretentious ting when I know this road gets bumpy. Word to the broski J, he got different names.
I want a girl from around the way.
Yeah.
I can't have no pretentious thing when this road get bumpy. I need a rider is what he said, man. You know, you gotta die. You gotta be able to translate the shit, man. I feel like this Drake made this song, man, because the song's entitled War, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's titled War. And I feel like he made this shit, this sort of in code. And I'm going to say it's a mixture between, you know, maybe the Canadian slang and also incorporating UK grime in it, just the slang wise. And to me, he just made this shit just so he could talk greasy and crazy on it. You know what I'm saying? He's just, it's in cold. You know what I mean? I'm talking about some real shit because he said specifically, my bad, man.
No, go ahead.
But he says, what did he say? He said, if men get beaky, ring, ring, call up Gigi.
Don't do that, dude. Don't do that, man. No.
Oh, okay, right?
No. Please don't. And you can do the flow, but don't be like, yeah, that's no.
I feel like this is required. He said, if men get beaky, ring, ring, call up Gigi, do them neatly. Mm-hmm. Used to look up to a man from certain ends with tune on repeat. So he's talking about some dude that he looked up to from his ends, from his hood, that looks like the dude snitched. He said, thought he was a bad boy, then till he got pinched and he went PC, protective custody.
Yeah,
right. So he's talking about some real shit. I think he's speaking in code as a way to really talk about some real shit that him and his, you know what I'm saying, his cohorts have been going through. You know what I mean? So.
But what I would like to know, though,
is
to all our UK subs, man, everybody that listens to Grime, is he killing this?
Good question.
Is he killing this?
Yeah, because we got some people over there. We got some UK subs, man, that rock with the channel, man. To me, it sounded like he finessing the shit.
Yeah, to me,
it sounded like he kind of finessing it. But y'all be the judge, man. You guys are obviously in more of a understanding of that grime style than we are. So give us some feedback on that. All right, let's get back to it, guys.
Before I was ever around Kendall's, I was in Enzo dreaming up Enzo's. The woman I do end up with has to be a back, y'all just
bring that back. He said before I was around Kendall's.
Yeah.
I was at the ends dreaming up Enzo's before I was around Kendall Jenner's, right? I think that's that reference.
I think so. Yeah.
Kendall Jenner, Kendall's, right? And I was in the ends dreaming up Enzo's. You know what I mean? Dreaming up about money. He was in the ends in the hood dreaming about getting money. So before he was around Kendall Jenner, right? And Calabasas doing his thing, he was in the hood dreaming about money, man, trying to get money, right? So let me bring that back.
Thought he was a bad boy then till man got pinched and man went PC. Man went PC just like Della and Windows, some man been those. Before I was ever around Kendall's, I was in Enzo dreaming up Enzo's. The woman I do end up with has to be a backyard just like Munchie. Can't have no pretentious ting when I know this road gets bumpy. Word to the broski J, he got different names in different countries. Three whaps and a whip and we beat that case where man lived way too comfy. I don't do well with people making disses and making threats. Warrior man got flown like private jets for way less. I know you try to get one down on us ever since then, it's been stress. Cause you know the reps, them owe you one, and we always pay them debts. Wassa, just
I missed that because this beat got me mesmerized, man. This beat is hard right now.
It's hard and it has this ominous feel to it. You know what I mean? The tone to it. You know what I mean? I like the beat. But what did he say right here that I thought was kind of slacked out? He went into this whole, to me, it was him describing a scenario, some street shit, right?
A story, right?
Yeah. He said, three wops and a whip. We beat that case where man live way, way too comfy. I'm just adding in different ways trying to catch the flow.
Yeah.
It's not two, it's one way. And then he said, I don't do well with people making disses or making threats. Man got flown like private jets for way, way less. And he said, I know you try to get one down on us ever since then. It's been stressed because, you know, the reps them owe you one and we always pay them debts.
We always come back.
We always come back. We owe you one. So whoever he's talking about, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to mention Pusher. Well, I am mentioning Pusher, but I think that might be a stretch. I think it's just really talking about some street shit.
But I love that street talk, man. I love the way he's able to write the street talk slickly in his lines, man, in his rhymes. I mean,
Clever. Drake is clever. He just is. You know what I mean? Y'all know what it is, man.
No.
But you know, funny thing is, man, when this first started, I was like, I don't know if I like Drake doing this whole UK grime flow. But it's kind of growing on me, man, as we're listening to this. Yep. Let's keep it going.
I don't do well with people making disses and making threats. Warrior, man, got flown like private jets for way, way less. I know you try to get one down on us ever since then, it's been stress. Because you know the reps, them owe you one, and we always pay them debts. Wassa, just like the Crody Press, I don't do no pasta. Link with Skull and Cousin Jamie and Yard, and we dip on Gaza. Pasha, Sasha, pissed I was way too young at the time for slashings. You niggas spend too much time on captions, not enough time on action. Pick one man with slaps that's rapping. I bet he don't want no clashings. The LB pouch on chest is just for fashion. Niggas just acting. Are you dumb or stupid? The wheels on the roses, chromas, headshot domas. Just checked in at a hotel floor that we all got pulled in the room.
This shit kind of hot. Actually, when I first heard this, he was about to get this criticism, and he still might get a little bit, but this shit kind of hot. This surprisingly might make playlists.
I'm telling you. Soon as he started in his flow, I was like, don't know. But man, you gotta give it up to Drake, man. You gotta give it up to how he's how he approaches a track, man. And this is not supposed to be his sound. And I've always said that, man. If you go back and watch our reactions, man, I think you look at the way Drake moves, man, it's very strategic, man. The boy is a surgeon with this bitch, boy, you know, and he really capitalizes on things that are hot, you know? Mm-hmm. And I see him making moves. I'm like, you know what? That's kind of slick. And the way he's able to incorporate this cadence, to me, it sounds like he's killing it. Case in point was that other jam that he did with, who was that? The Spanish dude, Bad Bunny. I think, no, it was Mia.
He did kill that too, in my opinion. I thought that was what it was.
Yeah. And you know what was hot about that, man? Because I got a lot of people in my family, my family and my friends all speak Spanish except for me. Apologize, guys. But they even said that his Spanish.
I don't think these niggas was worried about you. I don't think they worried. Y'all think you're good.
But my point is saying that even in that song, that I've got people in my circle that told me he destroyed that. Like his Spanish was perfect. Wow. They said. Not broken. They said it was perfect. So my point of saying that is either whether someone taught him to do it and said, do it just like this, or if he's just a student of the game and just, you know, learned it himself, either way, he destroyed it,
yeah.
You know? And I think he's destroying this too, man. I mean, I gotta give credit where credit's due, man. The dude is slick.
He's just on autopilot.
Yeah.
Man. I love seeing somebody that's just completely in,
slick with
in his own. And I feel like this man's been in his own for just making shit sound good and understanding production and how he can approach different beats. I just think he's just in his own. But I do like that line. He says, you niggas spend way too much time on captions, not enough time on action.
Yeah, that's hard.
I'm too busy typing on the internet.
And Instagram and shit. Action. Yeah, you know
what I'm saying? I like that. Let's keep it going.
And I bet he don't want no clashes. The LB pouch on chest is just for fashion. Niggas just acting. Are you dumb or stupid? The wheels on the roses, chromas, headshot domas. Just checked in at a hotel floor that we on, got potent aromas. OVO, XO, link up, man, them drink up, me and the drillers. Hawking sticks and cash and baka, Gucci, P and Gilla. And the boy that sound like he sang on Thriller, you know that's been my nigga. Yeah, we just had to fix things, family, six things, we can't split up. As for the rest of the game, I'll do man dirty, man, I get two time. To me, that's just our side, I don't really care who rides on whose side. Bring 10 shots to the poolside, never seen none of these grown men outside. 4301, won't spare no one, niggas gotta know about Southside. Stepping out of line, get outlined, and you know I'm tied up stateside. Ringing man down when it takes sides, trying to get saved by the bell like Bayside. Prince, I carry that last name, that shit stays on me like brand names. Jazz just lined up brand new hantings, in nice guy on a mad team. Everyone I know has code names, anyone I'm beefing with is a no name. Niggas can't even win home games, they just gotta fall in line like Soul Train.
This is playlist for me.
This shit
kinda
hot.
Axel.
He said he can't even win home games.
Yeah. That is such a hard
line. He said y'all can't even win home games.
That's supposed to be an automatic win, right?
Bring a man down when they take sides. Trying to get saved by the bell like Bayside.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Hard. Everyone I know has code names. Anyone I'm beefing with
got no name. Nigga, you're not even relevant.
Niggas can't even win home games. Dude. They just gotta fall in line like Soul Train, he said. You know, this was
this is playlist for me.
I like Drake.
And I was a little worried when this started. But you look at what Drake's done, man. To me, he's still put it together in a way that it's still
accessible
him.
Too.
And it still sounds like Drake.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. You know, yeah, he's got that cadence, that grime cadence going, but it still sounds like him though.
Yeah.
So I think it was a great balance.
It's interesting.
It was a great balance of how he incorporated that to me.
Yeah.
Because it wasn't like he just carbon copied it and was like, I'm gonna sound exactly like the grime. You know, he's like, I'm gonna take some elements of it and I'm gonna incorporate it and still do what I do.
Yep.
So I think it was fire. And the beat, dude, I can't say enough about this beat. Who the fuck made this beat?
The beat is crazy. Axel Beats?
Dude.
Or AXL Beats, whatever.
Shout out to Axel or AXL Beats.
Crush that.
Killed that.
But one common denominator that you see, man, is I'm seeing a lot of different producers that Drake is working with.
Yeah.
What's the common denominator? Is this dude understands
how to put it together,
how to pick beats, the right beat for the right time. So that's fire. I'm not sure how the UK guys are going to respond to this.
I can't wait to hear the comments
on this. I want to see what the UK people say about
this.
Because I don't know if the UK guys are going to look at this as Drake sort of perpetrating it into a degree, you know what I mean, taking a style and trying to capitalize on the sound, or if they're going to look at it as him bringing more light to the sound. Because I think that's what I've seen in the UK in a few of the comments. You know, people will look at what Drake's doing and they're just looking at him as just... it's just biting their style and not necessarily looking at it as a way for them to get a little bit more exposure. You know, because more exposure creates more opportunity for more people. And I think, honestly, I think that that's what Drake's intention is. Yeah, I mean, he's going, of course, benefit from the shit. I think everybody should win.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Drake benefits because he's, you know, making a foreign style that's prevalent in a different area pop over here in the U.S. You know what I mean? And he's also, and of course, if he's the first one to do it, then of course he benefits from it. It keeps him hot in a degree, keeps him hot internationally.
Relevant,
so
all that.
I just don't know how you guys are going to look at that.
I can't wait to see the comments on that.
So Drake has been known to make music that essentially you just have to kind of understand what his situation is to really get a full idea of what he's talking about, right? In this particular case, I don't know who he's talking about. You know what I'm saying? So this is very, very, very personal.
Yeah.
And it just looks like he made this shit just to get some things off his chest, some street shit that him and his team really has been going through. But I the bottom line is, man, I saw Slick Lines in there. If you're looking at it objectively, Slick Lines in there is something that you could just bang. I'm not looking at this as being a lyrical masterpiece or anything like that, but it's still slick enough. And from virgin ears to that style, I feel like he finessed it.
Yeah.
I really do. So shout out to Drake, man. Again, choosing the right beats, understanding cadence and how to flow. This is hot to me. So that's it. If you guys enjoyed that, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I'm George. That's Ryan, Lost in Vegas.
We out.